Hello everybody, my name is Dr. Danthrax99, and today I'm doing another episode of the How to Be Cancer series, with today's episode all about Soldier. Before I start, let me just say this again real quick. This series is a sarcastic profile of the worst type of people who play each class. It is in no way my actual opinion, so when you hear me say things like, every unlockable weapon in TF2 is better than the stock weapons, I don't actually mean that. Okay? Alright. Alright, step one of this process is arguably the most important. You need to go out onto a trade server, or backpack TF singles area, and find yourself a medic girlfriend. You can't be a tryhard soldier without a pocket medic shoving her medigun 9/10 of the way up your ass. That medigun beam better be locked on you at all times. If she stops healing you for 1/8 of a second, you better straighten that bitch out. A good smack across the back of the head with a tire iron should do. That bitch needs to know that her place is no less than 2 feet behind you with a full Uber charge ready to pop at all times. Even if she just popped on you, bitch better have another Uber ready, or you need to go get the belt. She needs to be right up in your Kool-Aid. That way, when you inevitably encounter a sticky spammer, an overhealed heavy, or an actually competent spy, you both die together. The reason for this is the fact that you're both dead allots you the respawn time to tenderize your face like a pork loin. Now that your medic girlfriend is in the kitchen making you a sandwich, it's time to work on your cosmetic loadout. Nobody is gonna know that you have a 14-inch penis if you wear the Winter Woodsman and the Allfather. So, in order to remedy this, we're just gonna put this team captain on his head, and we're gonna get this Allfather off his face before I catch Ebola from looking at them.
You are fake news.
In the MISC slot, we're gonna run the pocket medic. This one's going to speak for itself, because we've already filled this episode's quota of tasteless wife-beating jokes. When it comes to equipping the right loadout for tryharding, pretty much any loadout will do. But since we're trying to teach you how to be a human Lennybind, we are gonna need something else. In the primary slot, I highly recommend running the Black Box. At the cost of one rocket per volley, you will never die as long as your medic girlfriend is also grabbing your booty. This is because health will be returned to you when you do damage to enemies. Equipping the Black Box is a surefire way to let everyone on the server know that you don't know how to stay alive without your medic girlfriend right by your side. Alright, secondary weapon. Buff Banner is not too bad, but I imagine this guy is probably using it to actually support his team. God, this guy's such a cuck. So, without further ado, we are going to equip the Conjurer. The reason we are equipping the Conjurer is that we will be able to passively regenerate more health than a medic. And we need that because we're going to be tanking more damage than a guy on PCP charging the police. For a melee weapon, we're going to equip the Disciplinary Action. There are two reasons for this. First, we can gain a speed boost just by whipping our teammates like plantation slaves. And the second is that it's always nice to have a visual in-game reminder of what's going to happen to our medic girlfriend if she drops Uber. Alright, loadout accomplished. This loadout is great. This loadout definitely says, yes, I do have priors for domestic violence. Thanks for asking. When tryharding in a pub, you better make sure that your bitch is wearing the same hat as you are, so everyone knows that she is your property and they need to just unbind their e-keys. It is of the utmost importance that you and your pocket overextend as far as humanly possible. You will not be doing anything for your team unless without Uber, you and your pocket rocket jump into the enemy's intel room, where there's a heavy, a pyro, and a demoman all guarding a level 3 sentry nest. If you die, it's because your team members are nothing but a pack of mouth-breathing fuckwits, and you need to take to the comms to alert them to this situation. You need to call them names, and plenty of them. I have a few choice ones you can use, like retard, cocksucker, fuckbag, bitch tits, weeaboo trash, fucking free to plays. Hey, wait, why are you guys vote kicking me? Oh, for fuck's sake. Nothing on Tryhard Pub Soldier is more essential than your pocket bitch being all up in your Kool-Aid. I know I've covered this enough, but it's vitally important enough to be worth rehashing again. Doing so ensures your safety and shows the world that the two of you have a Chris Brown and Rihanna-like relationship. Make sure you use the thanks emote after every kill. Showing your gratitude to enemy gamers for allowing you to perforate them in a sexual manner is a major part of the Tryhard Soldier Code of Conduct. When the match is finally over and you've shown the world you're capable of at least a 5 kill streak, make sure to leave your teammates with one last comment about them being no-skill rich kids who buy hats before angrily disconnecting from the server. Congratulations, recruit. You've graduated from the TF Academy of Tryhard Pub Soldiers. Carry this accomplishment with pride, and get out there, queue for casual, and compensate for your diminutive micro-dick. Alright folks, that's it for this episode. Coming up next time will be how to be a WM1 Pyro, so if you have any suggestions for that video, please let me know. I do consider them. Anyway, thank you for watching everyone, and until next time, I will see you when I see you.